I'm working currently at Unity. I've been here for 7 years now. I work as a developer advocate, which basically is helping developers in the world to succeed at making games or operating games. Yeah, I've been making games my entire career. That's the only thing I know. That's me in a nutshell.
That's awesome. Can you tell me a little bit more about what kind of role you take on making games and what your day-to-day is like at Unity?
Yes, yeah, absolutely. So before joining Unity, I'm a programmer using C# most of the time. I used to use XNA. Not sure if you remember XNA.
I never used XNA. No.
Yeah. but then I discovered Unity and I started using Unity with C# and Visual Studio. So at Unity, I don't necessarily do coding 8 hours a day. What I do mostly is work on content and materials to help people understand how to use the engine or use the Unity services. My day-to-day is basically play around with new tech, play games from our community. And yeah, it's pretty fun.
That sounds like a pretty great job.
It is, yeah.
Cool, it sounds like fun. So to give you a little bit of background on myself, I'm also a game developer. I'm an indie. I do all different parts of it, including the programming, the art side. I mostly work on first person stuff, 3D, okay. More realistic. And so I want to talk to you a little bit about some of the tools in game development and how the ones from Microsoft, like VS Code and Visual Studio, and how they integrate in with Unity. I love doing the actual code. I know you can make games with visual scripting and that kind of thing, but I really like doing the coding side. I know you said you use C# as well, of course, if you're using Unity. Well, I guess there's visual scripting in Unity now too. Have you tried that at all?
I haven't tried that. I'm pretty excited about the possibilities of that, particularly for people who don't know how to code, or maybe they feel like they don't want to learn like the syntax of coding and they just want to create something. And I think that's great. As you, I still feel like I want to write code and you know, have control over those things. But I used to be the same way with shader graph. And now after using shader graph, I really don't want to go back to coding. I just use the graph-based tool. But yeah, it's great to hear that you're also working in games, that you work on all the sides of development. So you're also like an artist, you also do those things?
Yeah, I've been doing all the different things. I work in Maya for the 3D stuff, Substance Painter, that kind of thing.
Okay,
yeah.
Wow. I wish I could do also those kind of things because
it's nice because when I need an asset, I can just go make it. I don't have to look for it wait on
great.
It. So with coding, I use VS Code. I have tried Visual Studio, and I have heard that it's way better for debugging, which I'll get to in a minute. What editor do you usually use yourself?
Yeah, I've been using Visual Studio ever since I can remember, but even from the times of early days of Unity with Mono, I think it was Mono developed, mm-hmm. I preferred using Visual Studio. I've used VS Code from time to time, particularly when I'm on my Mac. I tend to use VS Code just to see what's new, but I usually use Visual Studio, not VS Code. So yeah, I think what I use it for is mostly just doing the coding, having the IntelliSense and some debugging.
Yeah, for sure. I have tried a couple other engines and different languages within it. And I was like, not expecting it to give any recommendations because I was so new to it and I didn't really know what I was looking for. But I was using Tab9, which is like a similar to IntelliSense. There's also like Kite, which are these AI-driven code completion tools. I was using not too long ago Lua. I was trying to learn Lua. And it was like finishing my code and reminding me of the stuff and different ways of writing things. So it was really cool to see it work in different languages outside of one that I'm more familiar with.
Yeah. Can I ask you which other engines have you used, like for game making?
I tried Core a little bit. That was interesting. I haven't yet tried Unreal and I haven't yet tried Godot. I don't know. I like Unity. I'm happy to see.
Yeah, thank you.
To try other engines. So, and it works well for the type of games I'm making. It's also like there's, I'm so familiar with it now that I don't want to have to relearn anything. I like it how it works. I don't want to mess with it. Okay, so when you're coding and you're making games in Unity, what type of extensions do you use with either VS Code or Visual Studio that you like to use?
That's a good question. I don't think, besides the sometimes using the GitHub integration and some like shortcuts, I don't think I have other extensions on Visual Studio. Yeah, maybe you can recommend me some.
Oh, I'm so surprised. I have mine, like I have VS Code like decked out. I have lots of different code completion tools. I have like all the C# and Unity extensions just to give me little tips if I'm forgetting or if I'm like trying to remember something. It's there for me. I have the tab 9, yeah, which will help me remind what I've named things as well. I also have like a really fancy theme installed where it glows. It's a synthwave theme. It's kind of synthwave vibe. It glows. It's transparent. It also like has flames popping up as I type.
Okay. Nice. I've seen another one that as you type also has some particle effects and you can configure those.
Yeah, that's what I'm using for the flames. You could also have Can you tell me a little bit more about how you would set up debugging in Visual Studio, like with the breakpoints, whether you edit in the editor in play mode, or even I have only done a little bit of it where you build the game and then you still have the editor open and you can see, you can like debug the actual build project as you have Unity open. Can you tell me more, yeah, like the best way to go about that?
It's a great and interesting question. As part of my job, I don't really publish games, right? So I usually just work in the editor. I attach the editor to Visual Studio. I add the breakpoints. I inspect code. I inspect the results within Visual Studio. That's what I do. From time to time, I also do debugging with the built version of my game, also connecting to Visual Studio. Also part of the debugging experience, I guess, that I have includes the profiler, other extensions like render dog for inspecting like the rendering of the game. Depending on the platform that I'm targeting, I might use other stuff. But yeah, usually for code, for memory, is mostly Visual Studio and the Unity profiler.
That's great. Yeah. Thanks for going through that. Do you have any tips? Well, I've got you. Any tips for people who are new to Unity?
The most important tip for anyone is they should start small, right? We shouldn't target on making something too big, because game making is not necessarily difficult as making, I don't know, as doing a heart transplant or something like that, but definitely is not also extremely easy. You will need to learn C#, you will need to learn Unity, and then you will need to learn Maya and Photoshop, and suddenly you have to learn like 10 different things at the same time if you want to have like a 3D model, right? So I would recommend people to start small, making a clone of an old game, the classic Tetris or Asteroids. Otherwise, if you say, I want to learn game making, I think nobody ever learns everything needed to make games, right? So that would be my advice. Also, keep trying. At least allocate 1 hour every day or as much time as you have. Continue working, continue creating. I'm not sure if this happens to you, Lana, but if for any reason I'm on vacation and I stop coding or I stop using Unity or whatever, my brain kind of gets a bit rusty and takes me some time to go back into the mindset of, okay, this is what I was doing. So yeah, I think it's better to invest 30 minutes per day than investing 8 hours in a single day per month or something like that.
Yeah, those are both really good tips. I think starting small is always, anyone who's made any kind of game or worked in it at all has always gives that tip.
And still I've seen like dream too big and I start implementing something and I'm like, oh no, this is not going to take me the month that I was planning. It's going to take me way more time.
My whole life, in some cases.
Yeah, let's not forget that.
Yeah, for sure. And then the second tip was good as well. Not too long ago, I was spending a lot of time doing art, working on characters, and I didn't do any coding for a while. It took me a minute to get back into it. So I think that's a great tip to keep it up and not go too long without it.
Yeah, you don't need to use everything, but also, you know, get it. constant updates on what's going on, not only in Unity, like in the world of technology, things move so quickly that you have to be always up to date.
Speaking of, I wanted to ask you, do you have any tips for people who use Unity regularly to stay up to date and to keep up with the new features? I know there's a lot that have been added since I've been so focused on my project, I haven't really taken the time to learn the new features. Do you have any tips for people to stay up to date?
Yeah, I would say, before updating, always evaluate the release notes and learn if it makes sense for you to upgrade. Because, well, we do our best to make sure that we don't break anything. There's always going to be something that might break. One thing I'm going to say is try to always stay with the latest LTS version, the long-term support version. So right now we have 2020 LTS. Also, if you are using any version control systems or such as GitHub or similar, I will say, well, branch out, operate the project, see if things are working, if there are no regressions, etc., and then evaluate if you want to merge that branch.
That's definitely all good tips on that one as well. Is there anything else you wanted to share or add that's on topic?
I would say definitely, and I recommend this to every person that I meet, I would recommend everyone to learn how to make games, even if you're not interested in making games as a professional career. One, it's super fun. Two, you learn about coding. So I will say, try it. The tools are free. Unity is free. Other engines are free. The Visual Studio is free. Like I will always say that if you want to get into this professionally, also think about game making as a business, right? Because it is important to have a monetization structure, or at least something that will bring money back to you. Unless you're a millionaire, in that case, yeah, don't listen to me. But if not, think about that since day one.
Yeah, great tips again. I say the same thing. I know I tried learning to code. Well, I was doing like web development. I was trying different languages, and just going through and learning it as is kind of boring. But once you start seeing things moving around and like you can interact with it, it's such a fun way to learn how to program. So definitely second that. Coming up with a monetization strategy is also a great tip that I don't think gets talked about a lot, because people are so interested in their vision and the art side of it and completing the project, that the monetization is actually something that should be thought about right off the beginning when you're coming up with the plan. So that's a great tip as well.
I don't want people to think that this is not an art, or that we don't want people to express themselves. But yeah, also we need to do. If it's just a hobby and you have another job and you don't care about that, then that's a different story. But most of us, we want to live out of making games, right? So it's important to think about them.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, well put. Cool. Well, thank you so much. It was a pleasure meeting you. It was a pleasure getting to chat with you. And we'll see you later.
Thank you.